Welcome all of you. In the previous lecture, we have discussed the mathematical background or derivations associated with economic law dispatch considering transmission loss. We have seen the coordination equation, then penalty factor method, and also solution using beta coefficient, or other words called transmission loss coefficient, or simply loss coefficient. We have also seen how the transmission loss PI is related to the generated power PI, or we have expressed the transmission loss PL as a function of generated power PI. In this lecture, we will discuss some tutorials based on this. So on refreshing, this was our coordination equation, dFi by dPi plus lambda into dPl by dPi is equal to lambda. This is our coordination equation, and this dPl by dPi is the term associated with transmission loss. In order to solve this term, we have two methods. One is penalty factor method and another one was beta coefficient method. And in the penalty factor method, we have seen one penalty factor that is being represented, which is equal to 1 by 1 minus dPl by dPi. And the second method was beta coefficient method, and we have also seen that in that beta coefficient method, we will be representing the transmission loss like this. And also we have seen then dPl by dPi can be represented using this equation, or on substituting those things, we have seen that the power generated of a particular machine can be calculated using this equation. Till this we have seen in the previous lecture. Now today we will see when we will work out one problem and make this facts much more clear. So this is one question. Here it goes. The loss formula coefficient in 1 megawatt unit for a single 2 plant system is given by M and N values are given, VMN is given. Then df1 by dp1. What is df1 by dp1? Yes, incremental cost of first unit. Df2 by dp2, incremental cost of second unit. It is given. Calculate the operating schedule. That means we are supposed to calculate p1 and p2 corresponding to lambda is equal to 2.6. The value of lambda is also given. So whenever you are getting a question like this, it is clear that transmission loss should be considered because the coefficients bmn is given. Okay, and loss that is called the loss formula coefficient, that is right directly given. So how we can calculate P1? Yes, we have only one equation for that, isn't it? This was our equation to calculation of PI. This was the equation for calculating the generated power PI. What is given? Given value is 2.6, that is lambda, that is this lambda is given. Then what all things are given? Yes, in the question, it is one thing also given, M and N and BMN. That means this term here, it is M is 1, N is 1. So this term will be B11. Here M is 1, N is 2. So this term means B12. Here M is 2, N is 2. So this term will be B22. So that means that parameters are also given. Here B11, B12, B22 are given. Then what all are the other given parameters? Df1 by dp1 is given. Df2 by dp2 is also given. So now let's see this equation. In this equation, what all things are known to us? Pi means power generated for a particular bus. Okay. So 1 minus, what is bi? Bi is the intercept. Intercept means we know the general expression is df by dpi is equal to ai pi plus bi. Okay, then BIM, that is beta coefficients, they are given. Then lambda is also given. Now let's try to expand this equation, because in the question it is given that there are two generators. That means we need to calculate P1 and P2. Let's first substitute I is equal to 1. So while substituting I is equal to 1, our equation become 1 minus B1 by lambda minus 2. What is M should not be equal to 1. So M should be equal to 2, right? B1 to P2 divided by A1 by lambda plus 2 B11. So you'll be getting an equation like this. P2, do we know the value of P2? No, we don't know the value of P2. So P2 is still unknown. So you'll be getting P1 in equation like this in terms of P2. Okay. Similarly, let's write what is P2. How will we be writing P2? By substituting I is equal to 2. Again, here also we will be getting the equation for P2 in terms of P1, because P1 is also unknown to us, right? So we have two sets of equation and two unknowns, right? We have two sets of equation, and to solve the sets of equation, we need initial values of P1 and P2. Only then I can calculate what is this P2, what is this P1. Because for calculating P2, I need P1. For calculating P1, I need P2. So something has to be like compromise. So we need the initial values of P1 and P2. For that, we are first assuming that there is no transmission loss, and we are assuming that df1 by dp1 is equal to lambda. Okay, so if I am assuming like this, lambda is given, right? Lambda is given as 2.6. So I can write df1 by dp1 is equal to 2.6, or what is df1 by dp1? 0.01 p1 plus 2 is equal to 2.6, right? So I got p1 is equal to 60 megawatt. So I got some initial thing to start with. Once I get p1 is equal to this, similarly df2 by dp2 I can equate to 2.6, thereby I'll be getting p2 is equal to 1 value. Now these two are the initial values by assuming that there is no transmission loss. Because only by assuming there is no transmission loss, we can write dfi by dpi is equal to lambda. And now we are substituting this initial values of P1 and P2 in this equations. You'll be getting two particular values of P1 and P2. Okay. Two particular values of P1 and P2. And now we are comparing whether this is after first iteration. Before that, what was P1? P1 was 60. Now after first iteration, it is 49. Now before, initial value was 110 for P2. And after first iteration, it is now 54. Now we can see that the difference, power difference is very, very high. 10.23 is the power difference, which is very, very high. So we will be moving on to the next iteration. For the next iteration, we will be considering the P1, P2 as this. What is that? 49.77 and 54.61. Again, calculating, we got it as 41.68 and 53. We got, that is, the difference has been reduced right now. So usually the value of delta P should be less than 0.01. So here we can consider this difference is also very high. So we are moving on to the next iteration. So again, after this iteration, again, you got it as 41.15 and 52.34. You can continue this iteration until your change in delta changes to what, 0.01. Like that it continues. So for the time being, we are assuming that we are stopping the iteration here. We got finally P1 is equal to this and P2 is equal to this. So this is our operating schedule. Okay. This is our operating schedule. That is, power generator 1 will be generating this much power. Generator 2 will be generating this much of power. Okay. So this is our schedule. Now we are going to calculate what is the transmission loss. What is the transmission loss? Transmission loss is equal to this equation we know, right? In this equation, we'll be substituting the values for P1 and P2. You'll be getting a particular value. This is the transmission loss. So what is the total power generated? Total power generated is it equal to P1 plus P2? That is 41 point this thing plus this. This is the total power generated. Now what is the would be the total power demand? Power demand would be total power generated minus the transmission loss. Or in other words, we can say that the total power generated will be equal to the demand plus transmission loss. Okay, so this will be the total power demand. So this is how we proceed with the questions. We have seen, this type of questions are quite easy, very easy. Only thing is that we need to know this equation of power generation. By knowing this power generation, for proceeding with a problem like this, we need initial value. So in order to get an initial value, we are assuming that there is no loss, and we have considered the initial value as dfi by dpi is equal to lambda. and the initial value of lambda will be given directly. From this, we will be taking the initial power, initial value of power we will be considering, and after substituting this initial value of power, we will be getting the next set, and we will check whether the difference in power is very large. If the difference in power is very large, we will proceed with the next iteration while considering the first iteration values as to substitute in this. And we similarly will proceed like this, and finally we will reach at a particular value where we feel that the tolerance limit is met. And once the final generated power is obtained, what we will do, we will calculate the transmission loss. How will we can calculate the transmission line loss? We have an equation for that. So this much is a transmission loss. The total power generated means P1 plus P2. This much is the total power generated and this much is a transmission loss. So we can see that, we can say that the total power demand will be the difference of the power generation and the transmission loss. And now we are considering the same question. And it is given that the load demand is 160 megawatt. Here, the demand is directly given. Okay, demand is directly given, and we are asked to find out the economic schedule. The same thing, one thing given is P1 plus P2 should be equal to 160 megawatt. Okay, in the similar fashion, we will be seeing that df1 by dp1 is equal to this thing, df2 by dp2 is this thing, it is given. B11, B12, B22, and this is also directly given. To start, get an initial value of lambda, we need the initial value. And see, in this question, the lambda value is not given. Lambda value is not given in this question. And in the previous case, lambda value was given, but P1 plus P2 was not given. Here, the lambda value is not given. Instead, P1 plus P2 is equal to 160 megawatt is given. So how can we calculate? Like the way we proceeded with the first case, that is economic load dispatch without transmission loss, how would we consider df1 by dp1 is equal to df2 by dp2. On doing so, what? On doing so, you'll be getting one equation. Then we have another equation, that is p1 plus p2 is equal to 160. From that, you'll be getting p1 is equal to something and p2 is equal to yet another value. Okay? And once you get the value of P1 and P2, you can directly calculate the value of lambda from that. So in this case, lambda we got it as 2.55. Okay, lambda we got it as 2.55. Again, we will be proceeding like with P1 is equal to, in the similar fashion that we have proceeded in the previous case. Only difference is that in this case, lambda was not given. Okay. So here we have done, that is P1 plus P2. We have finally got the value of P1 and P2 as 46.33 megawatt and 51.33 megawatt. Okay. So our P1 plus P2 is equal to what you call 88.91 megawatt, which is less than our required value. So what you need to do, you need to choose a lambda to be much more higher. So here we have chosen the value for lambda is much more higher, that is 5. It is an arbitrary value, you can take any value which should be greater than the previous value. So in that case, we can proceed with as much as iteration we can. So here we have performed approximately 4 iterations and we got 2 particular values for P1 and P2. On adding this, I'll be getting approximately 189 point something. Okay, once I got this 189 point something as P1 and P2, I can calculate the transmission loss also. So once I get the transmission loss, I can say that the total demand is equal to total power generated minus transmission loss, which we got it as 163 point something, which is greater than the demand. Okay, so here the power demand is actually little more, so we can actually, the total power here is little more than what we require. So what we can do, we can now reduce the value of lambda. Okay, and again we can proceed with the same iteration. See, this is a method that we are adopting. These kinds of problems are not asked in university questions, but simply this much iterations are not usually asked, but the calculation of beta coefficient can be asked. Calculation of beta coefficients, or rather transmission loss, can be asked. But this entire things, these types of questions are not frequently asked in this, but we should understand, you should understand that these are the steps that we are adopting in order to proceed with this economic load dispatch problem. That is, first we will be initializing the value of lambda, then we'll be proceeding with this equation until our convergence criterion is met. Okay, so this is a way that we are proceeding. It is not usually asked. Now we are moving on to the next question, whereas this type of questions are usually asked. Okay, so here is a question. This is a university question. So these kind of questions will be asked for university under the section transmission laws. Now two bus system is given. If a load is 125 megawatt is transferred from bus 1, this is bus 1, to load, a load of 15.625 megawatt is required. A loss of 15.625 megawatt is occurred. Determine the generation schedule, that means P1 and P2, and the load demand. If cost of received power is 24 rupees per megawatt hour, solve the problem using coordinate equation, penalty factor method approach. Okay, and incremental cost is also given. Okay, now let's see the question. What is it asked? I mean, let's once again read the question. If a load of 125 megawatt is transmitted from bus 1 to load, a loss of 15.625 megawatt occur. So what is this? What does this mean? If first machine generate 125 megawatt, then the transmission loss would be 15.625. okay, so here the transmission loss, here the load is connected to what you call the second bus, so transmission loss will not be accounted for the power transferred from the second bus. Transmission loss only occur for the power transmission from the first bus. This is the factor to be considered. Okay, so what will be the equation of our transmission loss? Our general equation was P1 square B11 plus P2 square B22 plus 2P1 P2 B12, like that. Since the transmission loss by the second power is equal to 0, all the terms associated with P2 becomes 0 and our transmission loss becomes P1 square B11. Okay, so from that I can write the beta coefficient B11 is equal to PL by P1, that is 15.625 divided by 125 square. You got it as 0.001. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. So this entire thing was calculated based on this sentence here. This if is very important. If a load of 125 megawatt is transmitted, loss of this much has occurred. In this question, anywhere it is not mentioned that P1 is equal to 125. It is just mentioning that if P1 is equal to 125 megawatt, the transmission loss would be 15.625 megawatt. Okay, this entire thing is given in order to calculate this beta coefficient. Okay. Now next we will see. Okay, so if you have PL is equal to something, then you can directly say that dPL by dP1 is equal to 2P1B1 or 2, what was P1? 125, and B1 was this. So you got dPL by dP1 is equal to 0.25. Okay, so you got what is dPL by dP1. Now as per coordination equation, what was our equation? dF1 by dP1 plus lambda into dPL by dP1 is equal to lambda, or dF2 by dP2 plus lambda into dPL by dP2 is equal to lambda. Now what is dPL by dP1? We have calculated 0.25. What is dPL by dP2? Does this second generator cause any transmission loss? No, so it would be equal to 0. So I can see that dF1 by dP1 plus lambda into dPL by dP1 equal to lambda. Now it is given as something as 24 rupee per megawatt. That is nothing but our lambda. Lambda is given. Okay, lambda is given. And so I can, from this equation, lambda is given, dpl by dp1 we have just calculated, df1 by dp1 is given in the question. So in this entire equation, what is now the unknown? P1. Only one unknown, right? So you can easily calculate the value of P1 as 123.29 megawatt. Similarly, you got df2 by dp2 plus lambda into df dpl by dp2. Whereas dpl by dp2 is equal to 0. So here df2 by dp2 is equal to lambda. What is lambda? Lambda is equal to 24. What is df2 by dp2? It is 0.05 p2 plus 20. From that you will be getting 80 megawatt. So you got the operating schedule, right? P1 is equal to 123 point something. P2 is equal to 80 megawatt. You got like this. Now how will you calculate the transmission loss? Transmission loss PL is equal to what? P1 square into B11. B11 you got it as 0.001. And P1 you got like this. So what is now the transmission loss? You got the transmission loss there. Now, if this is the power generated and this is the transmission loss, what is the total power demand? Total power demand will be total power generated minus transmission loss, which is approximately this. So, isn't this question very easy? So, this type of questions can be expected in the university exam under the section transmission loss. Okay, so other problem that we have discussed, that is with help beta coefficients, are simply to make us understand the different steps associated with the calculation. So this is a much more practical way of calculating this problem. Now we are asked to do the same problem using penalty factor method. So by using penalty factor, we know that df by dp into penalty factor is equal to lambda. What is penalty factor? 1 by 1 minus dpl by dpi, or 1 by 1 minus dpl by dp1. What was dpl by dp1? We have just calculated, right? So this was it. So you can write your L1 is equal to 1 by 1 minus 0.002 into p1. So on substituting this equation over here, you'll be getting an equation in terms of P1, where only P1 is the unknown. On solving this, you'll be getting P1 like this. Similarly, df2 by dp2 into L2 is equal to this thing. So L2 is equal to 1 by 1 minus. So what is this term? This term was equal to 0. So L2 will be equal to 1. So again, you'll be getting like this as 80 megawatt. So in both cases, you got the schedule as the same value, approximately the same value. So once you get like this, the next step is calculation transmission losses. Once transmission loss is also calculated, you will be calculating the total power demand. Okay, so this is a previously asked university question. Okay, and the only thing here we need to think about is the transmission loss equation. You need to know what is the transmission loss equation. And this here, one thing that should be made more clear is, why did we neglect this P2 under transmission loss? Because the load is connected here. So power from first generator has to transmit this much distance, and power from this second generator need to travel only this much distance. So here the transmission loss can be neglected, whereas here transmission loss is to be considered. Okay, that is a real reason. So that was a case considering the transmission loss using penalty factor. So this is actually a flow chart. Again, this flow chart is not asked as of now, but even then we can directly write this flow chart. Can you say this flow chart? This is a flow chart considering economic load dispatch, considering transmission loss. Here, how are we calculating the power? Do you remember this equation that we have just seen? 1 minus a by lambda minus 2 into that same equation. The same thing is copied here. Then after that, once the powers are calculated, here do you remember when the power difference is not less than our tolerance, we will go for second iteration, or we will go for the next iteration. For the next iteration, we will be using k is equal to k plus 1. Okay, once all the powers are calculated, then we will be calculating the transmission loss PL. And see, all this transmission loss will be calculated. And if your power demand is not met, what we will do? We will increment the lambda, or we will decrement the lambda until our power demand is met. So first step will be, we will be reading the AI, we will be reading the BI, total power demand, then maximum power, minimum power, value of lambda, like that. Set k is equal to 1 means first iteration we are going to the k is equal to 0, and here n is equal to 1 means first unit to the first generator we are considering. Similarly, if there are n number of generators or n number of units, we have to do this n number of times. Okay, so this is the flowchart associated with economic load dispatch, mainly accounting considering beta coefficient or transmission loss formula. Okay, so far in this module we have seen under the economic load dispatch. On summarizing, you can say that economic load dispatch neglecting transmission loss and economic load dispatch considering transmission loss. Before that, we have seen what is unit commitment problem and what is economic load dispatch problem, different system constraints, equality constraint, inequality constraint, soft constraint, hard constraint, then what all are the different generator constraint, then characteristics of thermal power plant, that is cost characteristics, incremental cost characteristics. Then we have derived the coordination equation, and in the coordination equation, in order to solve for the transmission loss, we have adopted two methods. One is a penalty factor method, and another method is beta coefficient or transmission loss coefficient, or simply loss coefficient, or otherwise called loss formula. So this loss formula or penalty factor method is used in order to calculate the transmission loss of transmission. Okay, so in this module we have seen how the power is being scheduled to different generators or different plants by considering certain constraints. Okay, so in the university exam point of view, the short answers that can be asked are, first thing is, what are transmission loss formula or derived transmission loss formula? Then what is beta coefficient or what is transmission loss coefficient? Now next is derive an equation showing transmission loss as a function of power generation. Another thing is discuss the different system constraints. Then the essay questions that can be asked are derived coordination equation. Then a sure question will be the one problem from the economic load dispatch neglecting transmission loss in order to calculate the total fuel cost. Now what is this objective function, what is constraint, what is Lagrange function, like that. Another short answer question is, what is penalty factor method? So these are all the short answers coming under economic load dispatch section. Now under the section unit commitment, unit commitment itself is asked as an essay. What are the constraints associated with unit commitment, or what is unit commitment problem? Now different constraints of the unit commitment separately can be asked as a short answer question as well. So these are all some direct questions or all the expected questions in the university from this module. So if you pay a little attention to this module, it is easy for you to score 20 marks from this module. Okay, it is a very easy module in the course power system analysis. So if you have any doubt in the entire module, please feel free to contact me in the comment box, or you can message me or call me. Okay, thank you.